千里江山图它就像是古人对我们后人的这份馈赠，
我觉得它像是一个礼物，也像是一张请柬。
Let's take a look.
There's some really interesting costumes of the hairdo. It's a crazy stage as well, with the whole archers and everything.
Floating in?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, no, that's an impressive shot. for doing traditional callbacks, right? This hairstyle, I don't know if a hairstyle is...
But that's the one thing good with Chinese artists. They're quite good at blending modern with traditional.How do they not fall over?
Well, yeah, no, this mix of traditional Chinese instruments and the music plus more modern percussion. All of this performance is an extension.
It creates an illusion of length.
Mm.
Look
at that. Oh my goodness.
That. Look at
that. All right, well, we've reached the end of the performance. That was incredible.
Lovely.
Yeah, no, there's definitely some questions to ask.
Like individually, when you look at the movements, like when you bend your bodies over like that, it's just impossible, you know? How much training did it go into that?
它首先是要看演员和主创团队以及导演的配合度。我们和导演的配合度是非常高的，所以我们在2021年3月份开始进行出排。到9月份是进行的首演，大概有6个月的时间。主创团队的一些，选题包括研究，应该也用了有1年多的时间。
All right, so I was really curious about the patterns that you're forming. To me, it almost looks like it was flowers at some points. Could you tell me about what the significance of these structures that you're forming is?
其实就是大家比较熟悉的青绿腰。我们在剧中的话，我们给它取的名字叫做险峰。它会在一段非常激昂的音乐里边，很缓慢的下腰到这个位置。在这一趴当中表现的就是，山峦的这种在千年万年的这种历史长河当中，它不断的变化它的这种形态，而形成的那种非常壮丽的气势。
This dance was inspired by a painting. That's really interesting.
So can you tell us a little bit more about what was the intent between the dance and the painting?
千里江山图当中那个时青时绿就是代表着我们这个角色青绿。当千里江山图它做一件工艺品的时候，它也是凝聚了我们古代人不同领域的一种匠心精魂。
When you're leading a troupe that's this large, what's the most important thing? Obviously, the performers are part of a bigger whole than themselves. Is there anything in particular to keep in mind?
对于栀子青绿而言的话，其实更加是一种我们对于中国传统绘画、对于中国，这个绘画审美留白的一些表达。你会发现横平竖直的队形比较少，形散而神不散的状态比较多，所以在这个里边，每个环节其实都包含着我们对于构图的一个理解，尤其是对于传统审美的一个构图。比如说第一段的唱丝，它的高低错落，它其实就有点很像这个我们古代的残肢图。其实我们有过很多的外国的这个观众群。比如说我记得那时候很早刚刚出来，我们在佛山演出，我记得当时有一个这个国外的从事秀的这个工作，当时我们演完出以后，他在前厅拉住我们说，你们的作品一定要去法国，一定要去，我相信我的法国的人民一定会喜欢的。他说这是我看过的最美的一场秀，所以这次过来香港也是我们2024嘛，因为我们参照了欧美的大概30多个剧院的参数，去做了这个相较国内的尺寸要略略的收窄了一些，但是所有的内容没有改变，所以香港作为这个版本舞美的一个首站，也是我们走向世界的一个窗口。有一句话可能大家听了很多年，就是民族的就是世界的，无论任何一个国家，你都会被它古老而悠久的文化所震撼。我觉得中华传统文化也一定不例外。